Hey everybody, this is Bobo the Vulture, and I'm beginning to get confused. Mr. Lightman appears to be watching me because he figured out what brand of string cheese I was eating during the break. No string cheese! thank you, Alt. This is Castlevania Harmony of Dissonance. No spring cheese. It's time to get back to it. We're basically on a little run of exploration since we got the. Obama's post-string cheese America. What are you talking about? Don't tell me you believe that Trump is going to make America great again by restoring string cheese to the masses. Oh man, remember those things? The Arabakis? I've had other string cheeses, little mozzarella strings that I don't mind. Polio has the best mozzarella. Well, string cheese in this instance is mozzarella. I tend to find mozzarella is just the best string cheese, though. Hey, Pike Master, take it easy. Trump reminds me of Armstrong from Metal Gear Rising. I did not play Metal Gear Rising. It's still on our to-do list, JG and I, going through the curd straight from the cheese factory. Yeah, no, it's on our to-do list. Right now we are playing Metal Gear Solid 5. I'm dead. I thought that might happen. It's been a while since we saw the game over screen anyways, right? And since we just got started, I didn't feel too bad about it. I got piked. Yeah. Besides, we haven't heard the load music in a while. Barter says, we do not serve time travelers around here. A time traveler walks into a bar. Ha! I get it, Dion. Neon, Dion, DF. Note, may not actually be nickname. Curse you, Fleeman. Do you have invincibility frames? Is that the problem? There are two kinds of people in this world. Those who can extrapolate from limited data. Ah, yes. I just figured out I'd get some of these guys back really quickly. That actually meaning too. You know what? Forget the spell book. That's right, Pike Master. I used just plain old weaponry on you. What are you gonna do about it? That's right, nothing. It's gonna kill me anyway. Aha! Well, thankfully, I'm back to being really close to the save room, so there's that. Wow. I come from the reputation of Grimmoth. That's happened before. I'm not going to deny it. Oh. Got Hazel the cat back there. Alright, Dion. This is, you know, this is not the kind of game that Grimmoth usually does, obviously. Playing an action platformer. I believe he first started watching me when I was doing Aerobiz for Sonic, which I might could do. I do have a game I was in the middle of playing of that. We just ordered Pizza Hut because all this mozzarella talk got everybody hungry. Yes. Oh, okay. That's good news. This is not the oldest of old platformers, but it's on Game Boy Advance, so it has sort of a Super Nintendo-y feel. What were we in that game again? Singapore? No. We were East Berlin. That was turning out to be kind of a problem. Because nobody liked East Berlin. And when Perestroika hit, that only affected the Soviet Union. That's true. You're gonna have to stick around for fancy dancing, or not, I guess. You're not obliged to stick around for fancy dancing just because. Yeah, I was not. I didn't have a Game Boy Advance at the time, and you know, looking at it now, it's like, oh well, shoot. This is kind of the last cartridge-based system, really. I guess DS has the little memory card things that are sort of like cartridges, but, Indie Box is bringing back the box. I have been a character in ROT... yeah, I have been a character in some of Grimmoth's ROTK games. I was also a linebacker on his NFL Street team. Where else have I been? I may have been a named person in a in an LCS game. The Viking Helm. I'm a soldier in the Tactics Ogre Army. Nice! My influence is spreading all around the world. See, this is one of the reasons I really do need to do an LP where I can name a bunch of random characters. I mean, I gotta pay back. Let's see here. Wait, obviously the Viking Helm is not that sort of an item. A helmet often used by the Vikings. Ha! I find it somewhat heartening, I suppose, to know that there are offices out there where everybody's watching LPs. That's not exactly what my office is like. Horned helmets weren't really a thing. Hey, quit ruining the game's fun and mine. Nope, okay. Uh-huh. Let's just let the flea armor hop into my diamond tip. Nobody objects to using dashboard screen for YouTube after work here. Play board games 3 days a week. Generic IT support company. Ah, I knew I should have gotten into IT support. I work for a political news website where I'm an editor. And, I'm getting kind of burnt out on politics, let me tell you. And he leaves, leaving the holy pukings behind. Alright, time for a heart smack dance. Man. There we go. Get back into it there. Might say for not to think about politics, having food in a czar and stuff. Yeah, there you go. So you fall asleep at night watching yours or grimace. RTS games, it's really just relaxing. Well, that's good. I used to be an editor, and then I wanted adventurer, so I left the city in search of glory and fame and money. You know what? That would be... Oh! The Skull Key! In Russia, we have a saying. Good sysadmin is a sysadmin who has nothing to do. Cool. Now I can get over here. Got all kinds of new places. Nope, don't want that Bible. It's not a good book to me. Right, trip your ass. And you left an axe. We have a guy who observes us and pays attention to who works too slowly and doesn't relax enough. Huh. Hey guys! What's going on, JG? My brother? So, what is essentially happening is, I have the ability to do moon jumps, that's the big thing. Brother from the same mother. Well, there you go, Dion, DF. If you've heard about me from an RTK playthrough of Grimace, you've probably also heard of JG. JG also ends up being a character on those a lot. Also, JG does a lot of RTK playthroughs, if you would be interested in seeing those. Have a kicker room, swimming room, pool. People who overwork can't find creative solutions. Well, just gonna watch that. You might bug out and take a nap. Oh, that's right. Oh, Deception 4. Now, I believe JG has the PS4 edition, which has some slightly different content. Of course, we hadn't even finished playing the PS3 version. I think there's multiple endings. The endings aren't vastly different from what I remember reading, but, like, yeah, you don't have to, you know, do what happened with us. Bobo JG in Second Densetsu 3. Wow. That's a throwback. I don't hear anybody say that one a lot. I tell ya! Legend of Mana? We've thought about Legend of Mana. We've played Legend of Mana for a while offline before. Whoa, look at these Simon rays. And they're high potions. And just couldn't really get into the sort of thread of it. Oh yeah. Sure, Server Nick. It occurred to me that there are a lot of people that don't have... See, the guy got fired. Working customer care. There we go, and have a little fun dancing. Just keep smacking these guys with my tip. And eventually they will give in. That's the lesson to be learned here, everyone. And not much happening up here. Alright. Except fabulous money. Ah, my classic dangling method. I hadn't done that for a long time since I got the, my new tip. But, it seems to work out very well. Spelunky's a fun game, too, that I've thought, like, maybe I should try doing an LPF sometime, but, how's that owl flying in the earth? Come on, owl. Let's be real here.
Your tip is on the list of the dirty things in life.
That's right. Simon and Garfunkel. Not Simon and Garfunkel, Hall and Oates. I actually got that confused because I was thinking of the musical group Garfunkel and Oates. Oops. David Bowie's spirit. Aww. Oh, I suppose David Bowie's spirit wouldn't be that disappointed if I was attacking it with my tip. Aha! Simon and Garfunkel's rendition of Your Kisses on My Lips. That would be pretty good. Hey, candle holder! More stuff for my room, everybody! I'm gonna have the most posh digs. All digs. Alright, one step over. What a weird-looking little statue over there that does not appear to be breakable. Mr. Sun, why you be shining in my eyes? Yeah. That is a, oh, that's a version of Scarborough Fair.
Are you gonna go get past the Prosperantum? Remember friends of mine.
Crush Boots. Let's check it out. Kona Crush Boots, brother. Used with high jump, it's possible to smash through some ceilings, brother. Oh, so these are the boots you're supposed to use to get through those gold. There you go. Crash boots, das boot of the crashing. That's not you, bruh. Oh, it's like, oh yeah. All the waka boots, they're not forbidden machina, they're just boots. Man. But yes, these are another item that we can use to break through certain barriers. Just gotta remember, I gotta use the Crush Bruce, brother. I do say brother a lot. That's also something that Kona Crush, a character that a wrestler named Brian Adams, not that Brian Adams. Let's wear Das Boots. Wunderwasser Boots. But yeah. A professional wrestler whose actual name, I believe, was Brian Adams, which, you know, getting back into 80s music again. went by. Yeah, Demolition Smash. Well, no, he was Demolition Crush, sorry. There was a Demolition Crush. Basically, Demolition Axe left Demolition, or was, you know, fired from Demolition, or whatever it is. But Smash was still there, so then they had the team of Smash and Crush. Das Boot is a book about, yeah. It is a book about a submarine, but it comes from the fact that Germans called their submarines U-boats. Or U-boot or whatever. Like, boot was, yeah, U-boat, underwater boat. Yeah, after Demolition broke up, you had Crush and Repo Man, and then... I think they both ended up in WCW for some period of time. But, you can use the skull key to get back and forth here now. You guys remember back here? Everything's coming together! The high potion is not absinthe, if that is what you were thinking it was. A potion to get you high. They both joined the NWO. I don't know if Barry Dorso ever did end up joining the NWO. He was, I think it was Larry Mr. Hole in One Dorso for a while. Or Barry Hole in One Dorso, whatever it is. Holy crap! I was looking at the chat and not taking the threat of the Simons seriously. So the rooms respawn. Can you walk back and forth between two rooms and gain full health? But you don't actually gain health from going back and forth through rooms. The enemies will respawn, so you can do things that way. That's a lot of stuff I didn't do. Yeah, you can grind levels that way for sure. The chandeliers are dropping hearts. Hearts are used for your weapon meter. It's kind of weird. In most games, you would think the hearts would be for your life. Your life is not actually recharged by any sort of item that gets dropped like that. Like, for example, let's see. Do I have a spellbook equipped currently? I shut off the windbook. But like here, I have a secondary item of holy water. I don't use it very much, but you see the 254 up there? Now I have 251 hearts. Now I have 248. Yeah, so that's how they work. Yeah. It is kind of weird, because pretty much every other game ever, hearts mean life. Just not this one. Because they thought they were going to be different. Anyways, let's get back down to the bottom here. We have to re-explore this whole area, because we didn't explore it. And I'm going to want 100% completion. Both because that's the kind of guy I am, and you never know. It might actually have some effect on... Might have some effect on the game. Ah, yes, and if I combine it with the wind book... In this game, after you die, hit select button here to go back to the map of the world. Those red dots on the map are save rooms. You go to back to the... Basically, you can save in those, so you'll go back to the last time you did that. That's more or less it. Oh, also the yellow dots that you see hop you back and forth between Castle A and Castle B. Basically, there are two different worlds or dimensions or something like that. And trying to basically explore all the castle. You can see that they have the overlay of the two of them together. There are a few areas in lime green. Those are areas that I've only explored in Castle B. A few areas in dark blue. Those are areas I've only explored in Castle A. And then the cyan areas are ones that I've explored in both. I don't know where all this game got released. I would imagine it got a fairly broad release because the Castlevania games, you know, I mean, if I don't honestly know how particularly popular Game Boy Advance was as a platform in EU, but it, you know, if it was at all popular and it wasn't the sort of thing, like in America, there are a lot of games like for TurboGrafx-16, for example. TurboGrafx-16 was a platform that did really well in Japan, didn't do very well at all in the US. Sega Master System maybe is a better example. Sega Master System did pretty well in Europe and pretty well in Japan, didn't really catch on in the US, so there's a lot of games that just never got released in the US for the Sega Master System. Mr. Lightman, where are you? That the TurboGrafx-16 did alright. In the US, not nearly as well as there. Yeah. Oh, right, I wanted to equip that helmet, because it's a good helmet. The Viking helmet. There we go. Yeah, no, TurboGrafx is one of those ones, like, for those that maybe didn't know or weren't thinking about it, I like collecting old gaming stuff, some of the old hardware, some of the old software, old cartridge sort of era stuff. Yeah, the Turbo Duo or Turbo CD. Let's do a little smacky dance here. Honestly, yeah, Ys 1 and 2, Last Alert. Yeah, no, there are a lot of good games. I will probably or may eventually end up getting Ys 1 and 2 for, or Ys, I don't know, however you want to call it. Yeah. Neo Geos, I feel like those are still super expensive. Like the home consoles of them. And considering you can get so many of the games that were released for Neo Geo on, like, Steam or other virtual console arrangements. They're not expensive anymore? How not expensive is not expensive? Because if you start telling me. Neo Geo consoles come with multi-cores. Oh, are you talking about that Neo Geo emulator thing? Yeah, that's not legit. Oh, is that one of those, they put a lot of games onto it. Is this a... Wait, I don't want to go back here and talk to you again. I've had enough of talking to you. I'm dropping down here. Yeah, multi-title. Is that one of those, like, EverDrive games? Good call, JG. That Neo Geo CD Samurai Spirits RPG. Mm-hmm. apparently Simon raids you just have to, you know, like, knock out fast. Alright, time for the lifelink stance. Got a little bit of this. A little bit of this. A little bit of that. Hey, and another level. That's good. The Noon Star. Jeez, suppose if you had a stack of those enemies ganging up on you, that would be... I am... Lightman is explaining something about Neo Geos. I'm not really even sure what exactly is going on over there. Yeah, no, I've heard about that one, but, yeah. Downwards attack with a hanging whip was fancy. Not one of the old games. Yeah, no, it was, I think it was like Super Castlevania 4 sort of a strategy. Yeah, no, I remember you were, I get what you're talking about. I thought you were talking about the, this is, you're saying prices for the old, AES systems have dropped? Because if that's so, that's kind of fun news. Check it out. I mean, I suppose in theory it's still kind of a silly thing to have. Yeah. Or heck, if it weren't for the fact that I lived in a relatively small apartment, I would be all about having a Neo Geo multi-cabinet, a multi-cade cabinet. That's a lot of damage that Simon Wraith did there. There. Had to get back up here for the crush brutes, brought off. And now that I've done that, well, one thing I want to do. Go back, set up my spellbook again so I can do the rain attack. Simon killed me in 4 hits when I was asleep at the wheel. Well, and I think there was a bird there that also dived in and didn't attack. The birds have surprisingly, yeah, like, rough damage that they do to you. Anyhow. I guess I'll keep rolling, because I kind of want to reach a save room. I kind of like to end my videos at save rooms so that everybody knows exactly what's up. Tell you what, Mr. Lightman, if you have just informed everybody that there's been some sort of massive dropout, like bottom drop in the market for Neo Geo systems and games and such, then, yeah, I feel like all of a sudden, like, this chat alone, this stream alone, is about to, create a run on that market. What? Passed up a decoration? Never! Video Games New York. Ouch! Guy hit me in the face. Where was this decoration, Ald? Was it in the previous room? I cannot miss exciting decorations for the... There was something back in the Crush Boots room. No. Oh, that smiling statue was... Yeah, it looked like it was just background. That was actually a decoration. Learn something every day. Hey, I don't feel like fighting you, owl. Just die using the rain. Japanese manuals. Well, if the games are in English, I think that was the big thing that JG was concerned about. There is a Samurai Showdown Samurai Spirits RPG. That, you know, is in Japanese, which made it a little difficult to play if you don't speak Japanese. As, you know, I don't believe really JG does a lot. I actually picked up, like, a Pimsleur book of Japanese at a Goodwill not long ago. Actually, I guess it was long ago now, but I haven't gotten around to trying to use it. What's used is one seller selling the arcade PCBs, and then another guy selling unattached manuals. Well, that's pretty cool. I have to admit. Neo Geo's worthy, ridiculous stuff of, like, otherworldly dream back when they were new, because they were, like, $300 or $500 or something like that. Alright. I'm using the skull key. I'm going to make my move toward the save room. Tell them about the PS1 game that runs up to $100 US. Yeah, no. There are still plenty of... You can still find plenty of rare things that cost ridiculous amounts of money. I have a copy... Oh, I wonder if that's a door that I can get through now. I'm going to save. And going to stop this episode for YouTube. And when we come back, we're going to find more exciting stuff to explore. I guess first I'll see whether or not I can go down this weird room... using any of my new abilities. I have a new key that's supposed to open, like, you needed to get a new Mega Drive so you could finish Hellfire 2 on Super Hard. I don't know, is Mr. Lightman able to post a link? I mean, yeah, I'm not gonna ban you for posting a link about something that we were talking about. That's okay. So, there you go, folks. That is something to look at if you are interested in that. Anyhow, cutting this off for YouTube, and we will be back next time. Thanks very much for watching.